I'd ask people, what are their goals? And they're like, oh, I want to go to the gym more. That's not a goal. That's a habit. People like, I want to get in better shape. That's not specific. It's got to be like a target, something you can hit. And how you build that in your mind, the vision, is very, very important as you bombard your subconscious. And many of you are doing mind movies or vision boards, things like that. But to really ingrain this into your being is going to be key. And so I love this phrase. This is the ultimate self-development formula that you've all heard before. Be, do, have. And so what you want to have, that's your goals. But all that's supported by your habits, your rituals, your standards, your story, your state. It's all the things that you're doing. And of course, I know we've all heard this before, we're not human doings, we're human beings. And so it's all in the context of who you be. Because two people can do the same things, have the same habits, have the same job, have the same script, you know, have the same goals, but one person will achieve it and one person not, based on the context of who they be. And who you be is all about what you value. People define their values. And because when I asked you what you value, or anybody, they're like success, love, happiness, wealth. But they say that, that's what they want their values to be, but that's not what their values are. So you could ask somebody what their values are by asking them questions like, if your house was about to burn down and you could only grab three things, what would you grab and what do they mean to you? Where do you spend your money? Where do you spend your time? Who do you spend your time with and what do they do for you? Like, reverse engineer what people's values are by looking at their actual habits and the way they show up. And if they sat in silence for an hour, you know, unless you're a master meditator, our minds are gonna drift somewhere. And so where does the mind go? It goes to what you value. And a lot of times what we want and what we value are in conflict. People want to be successful, but they actually value comfort and laziness and significance and looking good, looking like a success more than actually being successful. So that takes work. So habits versus goals, because those are the two things that you really want to dial in here at the end of the year, and always working on your values, always working on your character development. Because I love this phrase from Mr. Ralph Waldo Emerson. He said, who you are speaks so loudly, people can't even hear what you say. So as you're practicing those scripts, as you're sharing your goals, you've got to dial this in. You got to make sure that it's aligned, because most people have incongruency in their life. Their words are here with their goals. They say they're going to do something. Their words are here, but their actions are here, or their habits. Their mind's all over the place, emotionally scattered. But when your words, your thoughts, your actions are all in alignment, you say what you mean, you mean what you say, and your habits are in alignment with your goals, that is key. And things start to show up for you and start to open up for you. And so getting to the gym more, that's a habit. But you want to be specific even in that. It's finding something like going to the gym and then rating yourself. So if you had a spreadsheet and you could say like water intake, or, you know, go to the gym and, you know, 5 days a week or whatever it is, so you have this habit, but rating yourself, because sometimes you have shit workouts. Sometimes you work and you do prospecting or you're on sales calls and you did the habit, you did the thing, but you did it at like a low standard. And really dialing in these habits and tying that to your identity. I love that Tony's got this thing called strategy, story, state, but we also add standard. And so there are strategies in what you can do in your business and your marketing and everything, but all that's in the context of your story. And you have a story, consciously or unconsciously, tell about yourself, the market, your past, about the future, whatever. And then there's a state, there's a habitual pattern of what you focus on, the language that you use, the meaning that you attach to things, and then also how you ingrain all this in your physiology to have physical mastery over these concepts, where it's in you as you, and you're just pushing these things from a place of unlimited resources, of boundless energy, that is something that's coming through you because you are in alignment, and that's when things really begin to get juicy. So T is based upon the foundation. So you see all these buildings and you see all the success of other people, you see what they've created, but there's foundation, there's things beneath the surface that you can't even see. And that's the habits, that's the rituals, as our main man Tony always says, you're rewarded in public for what you practice in private. So you get really clear on what you want to practice, what you want to commit to, and being honest with yourself. And, you know, having that integrity with yourself. And integrity means wholeness. And I love this concept of integrity, because you even hear this word, like somebody says, you give your word. And it used to be, like, a couple hundred years ago, if you broke your word, like, you ruined your family's name. Now people lie all the time and it's not a big deal. So keeping this integrity with yourself, it's like, integrity is like wholeness and complete. And when you give somebody your word, it's like you're giving them something. And then if you keep your word, you've put something out there, like an intention, like a goal, you've kept your word, you put it out there and then it comes back to you, and now it comes back to you stronger. because now your mind and you're bonded to that person and you've kept a promise to them and you put it out there, you gave them your word, and then you kept it. And now when it comes back to you, you're actually bonded to that person where now energetically they're going to support you. I think it's so important for us to be in integrity with ourselves, what we say that we're going to do, and making sure that if we look down at what we track daily and weekly and monthly and yearly, whatever it is, to have this big plan for our lives, to make sure that we're living in alignment with our values so that we can really show up powerfully, not only for ourselves, but for our families, for our companies, for humanity. And life supports that, what supports life. And having a bigger vision than just yourself is what's going to connect you and really give you the emotional fuel that you need to step outside of yourself and be bigger than any challenge that could ever happen to you.